गुड मॉर्निंग चिल्ड्रन, चिल्ड्रन आई अप्रिशिएट यू दैट यू ऑल हैव सीन द चैप्टर वेल एंड आई विल से यू दैट द मोस्ट ऑफ द व्यूअर्स आर ऑफ योर्स एंड आई एम ग्लैड विथ यू क्लास 8 स्टूडेंट्स. आई अप्रिशिएट यू. आई एम वेरी ग्लैड. द वर्ड्स आर नॉट इनफ टू से दैट, इनफ टू एक्सप्रेस व्यूज दैट यू ऑल हैड सीन वीडियो वेल. चिल्ड्रन, दिस इज़ अवर नेक्स्ट चैप्टर, land, soil, water, natural vegetation and wildlife resources. In our previous chapter we studied water resources, natural resources, human made resources and human resources. Natural resources that are given by nature to us without any charge, and human made resources we extracted out the resources from the land that are available in nature. And natural resource, human made resource and human resource. Human is itself a resource. This I had expressed you in our first video. Children, this is our next video. After a month, I will say, but I will do best. I hope you also do best and put your good viewership over it. So, land is a resource, soil is a resource, water is a resource, natural vegetation is a resource, and wildlife is also a resource. Proceeding in the chapter, the chapter starts from a story. This is in a small village in Tanzania. In a small village, you all know village hamlets. In a small village in Tanzania, it is in African continent, country of Africa, Tanzania. Here lives a girl, Momba. Gets up very early in the morning to fetch water. She gets up early in the morning, you gets up early in the morning to study, and she gets up early in the morning to fetch water. She has to walk a long way. She has to walk a long way. Long way, you understand? Long way means a long journey. You can, journey is a broad thing. Long way means long distance. Momba gets up very early in the morning. She has to walk a long way and returns after a few hours. After coming from after collecting water, she then helps her mother in the house. First she collects water, then she helps her mother and joins her brother. After that she joins her brother in taking care of their goods. After that she starts taking care of the goods. I think you all are just working at home and studying. There is no work like this, like Momba, to take care of the goods. Okay, so children, all her family owns is a piece of rocky land. All her family owns is a piece of rocky land around their small hut. Means the whole sole ownership is the rocky land side by them. And but Momba's father can barely grow some maize and bears on it after toiling hard, and beans on it after toiling hard. Means he only can grow maize and beans because it is a rocky land, not fertile land. So he is, after a hard work, he only can gain maize and beans. This is not enough to feed their family for the whole year. So children, as you all know, the rocky land is not so fertile to get more of the produce from the land. So he collects only maize and bean, and this is not sufficient to feed her family for a long time. So here is the given, next it is given, let's do. Observe the land, type of soil and water availability in the region. Water in the region you live. Discuss in your class how it has influenced the lifestyle of people there. Children, wherever you live, you watch the land. You see the land, how, which type of land. I just say, in India, if you are in Jammu Kashmir and Uttarakhand and the surrounding area, Uttarakhand, UP and Bihar, West Bengal and the Northeastern states, Seven Sisters. And in the southern part of India, there is the hilly region. And as hilly regions are not so much fertile, like this you can just judge it out and see what is the availability of water. And all one thing more, there is also a great problem in hilly regions. Water's availability is less. You know, I am just giving an example. You just observe it in each place of India. Observe in your class how it has influenced the lifestyle of people there. Means these things, if they are available, how they are done, they are doing, the villagers, the people of that area are doing, and if the and the places where they are available, how they are leading their life. You can observe it out and write down. This is the exercise. Let's do, and you have to do it in the copy. It's a homework. Next, let's proceed to the chapter. Peter lives in the heart of the sheep rearing region in New Zealand. Now this is another story about New Zealand. You know where is New Zealand? New Zealand, south of Australia. You know that there is the cricketers team is also of New Zealand. You can be familiar with this as you are in class 8. I know you are not so much familiar of the worldly states. So be familiar. I am telling you, it is in the south of Australia, in East Australia. It is a type of island view, same like Mozambique in the African states, African continent. It is after Australian continent. It is New Zealand. So Peter lives in the heart of sheep rearing region in the New Zealand. Peter is living in the sheep rearing region where sheep are reared means taken care of, where his family runs a wool processing factory, and productivity there, that this region, as it is in sheep rearing region, so they are gaining wool from it, and Peter is having a wool processing factory. Every day when he returns from school, Peter watches his uncle. See, watch means see. Sees his uncle taking care of their sheep. He sees his uncle that he takes care of the sheep. Their sheep yard is situated on a wide grassy plain. Wide means long. Grassy with the greenery. Green grass, you all know. Green. Greenery, I will say straws. Grassy plain. Plain means not a hilly region. Grassy plain, wide grassy plain with hills in the far distance, and with the grassy plains there is the hilly region also in the far distance. It is managed in a scientific way using the latest technology. One thing it is more given here, it is managed in a scientific way. Whatsoever is done in the factory, it is in a scientific way using the latest technology. Means the rearing of the sheep is done with the latest technology. Peter's family also grows vegetables. The family of Peter, it is also growing vegetables through organic farming. You all know organic farming, I will say using organs. As you know, we use biotic fertilizers for doing agriculture. Same is organic, some artificial way, not so much natural. Organic farming is done there. Mamba and Peter stay in two different parts. Now there is a comparison given here. He is living in New Zealand, and Mamba is living in Africa, in Tanzania, and that is a hilly region, not fertile region, so he is unable to do any other type of production. So as it is a hilly region, he is only capable of growing maize and beans, and as it is, this is the New Zealand grassy land, also a hilly region, so Peter is not only growing I will say, what we have seen, the wool, but also he is doing organic agriculture. Means he has two productions there. You just imagine it, not imagine it, you just see it. So two productions because of the different of the resources, land and other resources. So this is the matter of resources. सो द डिफरेंस इज डिफरेंट पार्ट्स ऑफ द वर्ल्ड लीड वेरी डिफरेंट लाइव्स. दिस डिफरेंस इज बिकॉज द डिफरेंस इज इन द क्वालिटी ऑफ लैंड. वाई दिस इज डिफरेंट? दिस इज द डिफरेंस बिटवीन द क्वालिटी ऑफ लैंड मीन्स क्वालिटी ऑफ लैंड. समवेयर हिली, समवेयर ग्रासी लैंड. मीन्स इन तंजानिया हिली लैंड एंड इन न्यूजीलैंड ग्रासी लैंड. सो ग्रासी लैंड. तो दिस इज द डिफरेंस. वाई दिस इज द डिफरेंस? दिस इज द डिफरेंस ड्यू टू द लैंड, सॉयल, वाटर एंड नेचुरल वेजिटेशन, animals and the uses of technology. This is the difference due to this. I mean, these are all resources that are defined here. The availability of such resources is the main reason. The availability of such resources is the main reason places differ from each other. Availability of such resources is the main reason places differ from each other. Means resources make difference with the productivity. So now after that, this story we are starting towards the land resource. Land is among the most important natural resource. It covers only about 30% of the total area of the earth's surface. The total earth's surface on the globe, it is land is 30%. And all parts of this small percentage are not habitable. All parts of the small percentage are not habitable. Means 30% of the land that is available on the earth's surface, all is not to be habitable. Habitable means for living purposes. All places we can't reside. We can't live with their family because of the unavailability of the resources. Like somewhere water is not available. Like in Thar Desert, if you want to reside there, it is a huge difficulty to live there, you know, because there is no water. So what to do? Our civilization started nearby rivers. Why nearby rivers? Because the availability of water. So the resources matter. All parts of this small percentage are not habitable. Means 30% of the land is lying on the earth's surface, but still due to difference of resources, we cannot reside everywhere. So this is the matter, the land resource. Now next thing, do you know is coming. 90% of the world population occupies only 30% of land area. 90% of the world population, 90% of the world population occupies only 30% of the land area. Means whatsoever the land area available, in that land area that is available, only 30% is occupied by the population. The remaining 70% of the land is either sparsely populated or uninhabited. Means sparsely populated means fragmented population in parts, somewhere 20 after 100 kilometers, somewhere 20 or 100 people are residing like this sparsely. 10 somewhere, 20 somewhere, 30 somewhere, 100 somewhere, 1000 somewhere. Means after a long, sparsely populated distribution, fragmented form or inhabited. And somewhere people are not living there. Uninhabited means some are totally left. People are not living there. Okay. The next it is going. The uneven distribution of population in different parts of the world is mainly due to varied characteristic of land and climate. The uneven distribution, uneven distribution of population in different parts of the world is mainly due to varied characteristic of land and climate. Okay, land and climate, this makes the unevenness in the distribution of population due to the land and climate. Somewhere it is very mild, somewhere it is harsh, somewhere it is very good to live, and in land somewhere it is hilly, lacking water, somewhere it is lacking different requirements lacking, and people are not residing there. So the uneven distribution of population in different parts of the world is mainly due to varied characteristic of land and climate. The rugged topography, steep slopes of the mountain, low-lying areas susceptible to water logging, डेजर्ट एरियाज, थिक फॉरेस्ट एरिया आर नॉर्मली स्पार्स पॉपुलेटेड और इनहेबिटेड. ही टोल्ड द क्वालिटी ऑफ लैंड वेयर द पीपल रिजाइड लेस, लाइक द रग्ड टोपोग्राफी, टोपोग्राफी द अप्स एंड डाउन ऑफ द लैंड, डिफरेंट टाइप्स ऑफ फीचर्स, अनइवननेस ऑफ द लैंड फीचर्स, स्टीप स्लोप्स ऑफ द माउंटेन, समवेयर द स्लोप्स ऑफ माउंटेन्स आर वेरी स्टीप, स्टीप मीन्स डायरेक्ट वर्टिकल, लो लाइंग एरियाज ससेप्टिबल टू वाटर लॉजिंग एरिया, समवेयर लाइक इन उत्तराखंड देर इज द आई विल से क्लेई लैंड, मार्शी लैंड, सो पीपल आर नॉट रिजाइजिंग देयर, देयर हैपन्स द वाटर लॉजिंग. वाटर लॉजिंग मीन्स कलेक्टिंग ऑफ द वाटर. डेजर्ट एरियाज लाइक इन यू नो इन इंडिया देर इज द थार डेजर्ट, पीपल आर नॉट लिविंग देयर ड्यू नॉट लिविंग इन कंपेरिजन एज पीपल आर लिविंग इन प्लेन एरिया. यू सी अंडरस्टैंड इट. सो दिस क्रिएट्स अनइवननेस ऑफ द पॉपुलेशन. थिक फॉरेस्टेड एरियाज आर नॉर्मली स्पार्सली पॉपुलेटेड. थिक फॉरेस्ट समवेयर द फॉरेस्ट आर वेरी थिक, सो पीपल आर अनएबल टू लिव देयर, सो दे आर नॉट लिविंग देयर. पॉपुलेशन टर्न्स इन टू अनइवन, स्पार्सली पॉपुलेटेड और इनहेबिटेड. प्लेन्स एंड रिवर वैलीज ऑफर सुटेबल लैंड फॉर एग्रीकल्चर मीन्स सम एंड दिस इज अनदर डिस्ट्रीब्यूशन. समवेयर प्लेन्स एंड रिवर वैलीज, वेयर द प्लेन्स आर अवेलेबल, वेयर द रिवर वैलीज आर अवेलेबल, ऑफर सुटेबल लैंड फॉर एग्रीकल्चर, ऑफर सुटेबल लैंड फॉर एग्रीकल्चर, हैंस दीज आर द डेंसली पॉपुलेटेड एरिया ऑफ द वर्ल्ड. मीन्स समवेयर इफ प्लेन्स एंड रिवर वैलीज, सम द प्लेन्स दे आर फर्टाइल, रिवर्स द वाटर इज अवेलेबल, दे कैन डू एग्रीकल्चर, सो दे कैन फीड देयर स्टमक्स, सो दे आर लिविंग देयर, पीपल आर लिविंग देयर, सो दे दीज प्लेसेज आर डेंसली, डेंसली मीन्स वेरी वेरी ह्यूजली, इन अ ह्यूज अमाउंट पीपल आर रेजाइडिंग देयर, रेजाइडिंग इन द वर्ल्ड, नॉट ओनली इन इंडिया, ऑल ओवर द वर्ल्ड, वेर एवर द एग्रीकल्चर कैन बी डन वेल, लैंड इज सुटेबल एंड वाटर इज अवेलेबल ड्यू बाय द रिवर वैलीज और सम अदर मीन्स, द पीपल आर डेंसली पॉपुलेटेड देयर इन द वर्ल्ड. नाउ लैंड यूज, दिस वॉज द डिस्क्रिप्शन अबाउट लैंड. नाउ नाउ लैंड यूज, लैंड इज यूज फॉर डिफरेंट पर्पजेज सच एज एग्रीकल्चर, फॉरेस्ट्री, माइनिंग, बिल्डिंग हाउसेज, रोड्स एंड सेटिंग अप इंडस्ट्रीज. लैंड इज यूज फॉर डिफरेंट पर्पजेज, डिफरेंट पर्पजेज, डिफरेंट मीन्स सच एज सम डू एग्रीकल्चर, सम डू फॉरेस्ट्री, यू नो आई विल से डूइंग टिम्बर इंडस्ट्री, फॉरेस्ट्री, माइनिंग, बिल्डिंग हाउसेज, रोड्स एंड सेटिंग अप ऑफ इंडस्ट्री. दिस इज द लैंड यूज, दिस इज कॉमनली टर्म्ड एज लैंड यूज, दिस इज कॉमनली टर्म्ड एज लैंड यूज. मीन्स इफ दीज वर्क्स आर डन दे कैन बी डिस्क्राइब्ड एज दिस इज द लैंड यूज ऑफ द पीपल. Can you list out the different ways in which Mamba and Peter's family use their land? Okay, you can easily classify according to the hilly region and the region of New Zealand. You can see there was the grassy land, grassy plain land. After that, there are the hilly region. But in Tanzania, it is only a hilly region. He is unable to grow maize. He only can grow beans and maize. And in New Zealand. Peter's family is doing sheep rearing and also growing some agriculture. The use of land is determined by physical factors such as topography, soil, climate, minerals, availability of water. Means the use of land where the topography is good, soil is fertile, climate is good, minerals are available there, and the availability of these four five features makes proximity of the production. So this makes evenness and unevenness in the production of I will say grains. Human factors such as population, technology are also important determinants of land use pattern. Human factors such as population and technology are also Population and technology are also important deciding of land use patterns. If population is good, if they have technology, they can possess more production. Land can also be classified on the basis of ownership. Now the classification of land is done here. Private land and community land. Private land means individual land. Community land owning ownership of a group. Private land is owned by individuals. private land is owned by individuals, whereas community land is owned by the community. Whereas community land is owned by the community for common users, like collection of fodder, fruits, nuts, and medicinal herbs. These community lands are also called common property resources. These common lands are also called common property resources. These are also called common property resources. Collection of fodder, collection of fruits, collection of nuts, medicinal herbs. These may be the common property resources. People and their demands are ever growing, but the availability of land is limited. People and their demands are ever growing. People are growing, population is increasing, and as population increases, the demand is increasing. Demand is increasing. But the land is limited. Population is growing, demands are growing, but the land is limited. Limited means less. The quality of land also differs from place to place. And somewhere the same thing is here. The quality of land means the fertility of land differs from place to place. The goodness of land differs from one place to another. People started encroaching the common lands to build up commercial areas. What so people are commercial area, housing complexes in the urban areas. In the urban area, what people are doing? They are doing commercial, build up commercial areas, like making factories, making institutions, making different malls and all these things. Commercialization. Housing complexes, they are making housing complexes, flats they are making in the urban areas, and to expand the agricultural land in the rural areas. And in the rural areas, the people try to expand agricultural land. They clean the forest area. Today, the vast changes in the land use pattern also reflect the cultural change. Today, this is about today. The vast changes in the land use pattern also reflect the cultural changes in our society. Today, the vast changes in the land use pattern. As there are the huge changes going on the land use pattern, it also reflects the cultural changes in our society. We have the most of the proximity of land utilizing, so our culture is also changing. Our society is also changing. Land degradation, landslides, soil erosion, desertification are the major threats to the environment because of the expansion of agriculture and construction activities. There are harms. As we are studying land use pattern, that land use pattern also results land degradation. Land degradation means goodness of the land is decreased. Landslides, somewhere landslides. People are using land on the hilly area. They are making houses, they are making complexes, they are making factories. And whenever the it lost its porousness, it's lost its catching of the soil due to cleaning the forest, so happens the landslides, soil erosion. People are cutting hole of the trees that is holding the soil, and it results in the soil erosion and desertification. Excess use also results in desertification, and removing of trees also results in desertification. So there are many other reasons can be set for this harms. So these are the major threats to the environment because of the expansion of the agriculture and construction activity. Let's do construction activity means building houses, building factories, building complexes, building malls, building cinemas or institutions, all these things. They are also doing these harms, like land degradation, landslides, soil desertification, all the results of this. Let's do. Talk to some elderly person in your family or neighborhood and collect information about changes in the land use over the years in the place where you live. Display your findings on a bulletin board in your classroom. So this can be done. There are some pictures shown here. You need to find where you are living, what are the changes in last 80 years, last 100 years had happened. What your elderly people say, point it out and write it in a graphic chart, and then paste it in the display board of the class. These are the features that are shown here. Now the conservation of land resource. As our overusing of land use is going on, so I think it is necessary to conserve land resource also. So people, as population is growing, demand is increasing, and this is all resulting in the harm of land. So conservation is required. growing population and their ever growing demand has led to large scale destruction of forest cover. Population is growing, we are cleaning the forest and making our houses and agriculture farms. So growing of population and their ever growing demands has led to a large scale destruction of forest cover and arable land, and has created a fear of losing this natural resource. And this is creating destruction of forest cover, arable land, and has created a fear of losing this natural resource. So land is about to be extinct, so it is required to be conserved. Conservation is required. Therefore, the present rate of degradation of land must be checked. As the land is degrading, land is losing its quality, losing its fertility, so it is to be checked. Checked means we people have to take care of it. We have to see what are the harms we are doing to the land. Therefore, the present rate of degradation of land must be checked. Afforestation, land reclamation, regulated use of chemical pesticides and fertilizers, and checks on overgrazing are some of the common methods used to conserve land resources. So what we can do? Afforestation, what we have to do? Plant more trees. Land reclamation means the land that became barren, we have to plant more trees and again make it good for use. Now next is regulated use of chemical pesticides. We should have to reduce chemical pesticide. We should use herbal pesticide, biotic pesticides and fertilizers. Fertilizer, they should not harm. Fertilizers and pesticides should not be harmful from the land. That like this land can be conserved. Checks on overgrazing. People should not keep eye over overgrazing. Overgrazing means people are leaving the taking their cattle and making grazing of the cattle over the land, and this is harming the land, are some of the common methods used to conserve land. These are the measures that can be done to avoid land degradation. Now glossary, here is a defining weathering. Weathering is defined here. Weathering means the changes that happens climate and that resulted in the land harms. Weathering, like too much of hot season, too much of cold season, too much of rainy season, it all harms our land. So definition is given, a weathering, the breaking up and decay of exposed rocks by temperature changes, frost action, plants, animals, and this is a defined here definition, human activity. This is given you our definition given about weathering. Now land, in the land pattern, as we have seen land and land use pattern, next we are seeing soil. Children, the thin layer of grainy substance covering the surface of the earth is called soil. The thin layer of grainy substance, you know, size of a grain like wheat, maize, and like this, grainy substance covering the surface of the earth is called soil. It is closely linked to land. The soil is closely linked to land. Landforms determine the type of soil. Landforms means somewhere hilly region, somewhere plain region, they determines the type of soil. Soil is made up of organic matter, minerals and weathered rocks found on the earth. Minerals, you all know what are minerals: iron, aluminium, copper, mica, manganese, all these are minerals. Weathered rocks found on the earth. Weathered rocks, we will say weathered rocks means grainy rocks, eroded rocks found on the earth. This happens through the process of weathering. The right mix of minerals or organic make the soil fertile. If somewhere the right mix of minerals like potassium, sulfur, manganese, all these things are required for the good agriculture. So the right mix of minerals and organic matter makes the soil fertile. Organic matter that makes the land fertile. So this make the land good. Now landslides, children. Landslides often happens in hilly areas like northeastern states of India, like the hilly regions of Uttarakhand. There happens a grand landslides. Landslides are simply defined as the mass movement of rock, debris, or earth down slope. The landslides, you understand, washing away of the land, washing away of the land. Understand it carefully. They often take place in conjunction with earthquakes. They often take place in conjunction with earthquakes. They often take place in conjunction with earthquake. Whenever the earthquake happens, landslides happen, floods happen, volcanoes happen. During all these things, earthquakes, floods, and volcanoes, the landslides happens. Volcano, you all know, okay? And floods, the excess of water flow in the rivers, and earthquakes, the shivering of the crust. That is, that I can define in simple words. A prolonged spell of rainfall can cause heavy landslide. If heavy rainfall is going on, landslide can happen. That can block the flow of river for quite some time. The formation of river blocks can cause havoc to the settlements downstream on its bursting. The formation of river blocks can cause havoc to the settlements downstream